Hi, my name is Ken Rosenthal, and I'm a park naturalist here at Gulf Ranch Nature Center. And today we're going to go over some identification tips for identifying copperheads in the field. You might be asking why we are identifying copperheads. Well, copperheads are the only venomous snake that you'll find in northern Virginia, and we do have them in some of the areas in northern Arlington. There are three venomous snakes you can find in the state of Virginia. Timber rattlesnakes are typically found in more mountainous areas to the west and north of here. And the northern cottonmouth is found in the southeast corner of the state in the swampy areas down there. So you don't have to worry about those two. The only one we do have in our area, again, is the northern copperhead. This is a map from iNaturalists showing some data points of observations of northern copperheads in the area. This is all of Arlington County, and you'll see the only area that the copperheads have been spotted in is in this little area here, which is the Gulf Branch natural area, and then here is Potomac Overlook Regional Park. I know they have also been spotted down here in Fort C.F. Smith, so you'll find them along the Potomac, in these forested areas. And so if you enjoy recreating in these areas or spend a lot of time here, it's probably a good idea to know what these snakes look like. Of the three venomous snakes you'll find in Virginia, the copperheads have the least potent venom, and fatalities are very, very rare, obviously, with modern healthcare and services like 911. There's a lot of quick first aid and treatment you can get for a venomous snake bite. So, best tips for identifying a copperhead. We're going to stick with, initially, the easiest way to do that is you're looking for a snake that has bands, and they have alternating light and dark bands. And if you look along the snake here where these arrows are, you can see the dark bands narrow along the spine or the top of the snake. They widen as they go to the belly, but they narrow along the spine. And they may or may not connect. Here you can see they're connected. Here's spots where they don't connect. So don't worry about them being connected so much. Just make sure that you're seeing dark and light bands, and the dark bands are narrowest along the spine. From the top, they may even resemble an hourglass or a saddlebag pattern. From the side, I always tell people, look for the Hershey kisses. These dark bands, as they widen towards the belly and narrow at the top, they do look kind of like a Hershey kiss, no matter how dark or light the snake may be. Some less helpful tips, and I call these less helpful tips because typically to see these, you've got to be a little bit closer to the snake. You can notice that they have a coppery head and or that is shaped, is triangularly shaped. The triangular shape can be misleading because some snakes will flatten themselves to look more dangerous even though they're non-venomous, and they can give off when they flatten, they can look very much like they also have a triangular head even though they don't. And we'll see a picture of that in a minute here. I always hear people say you can look for the slit pupils. If you're close enough to see the shape of the pupil in the snake, you might be a little too close already. They do have a heat sensing pit between the nostril and the eye, and the snake's head does have a two-tone. This might not be as hard to see from a distance, but again, the closer you are to the head to see these features, the closer you may not need to be to a venomous snake. And then juveniles are smaller, and you can see right here, they have a brightly colored tail. If you see a small snake that has a pattern and it does not have a brightly colored tail, it is not a copperhead. This is something you'll see in a juvenile. And I want you to definitely take a look at that, because we're going to come back to this with a couple other snakes later on. So, snakes that are often mistaken for copperheads, the main one is a northern water snake. You can see they have a pattern of light and dark alternating bands, but theirs is the exact opposite. Where on the copperhead, the dark bands were narrowest at the top, these bands are widest at the top. So, if the bands are wide at the top along the spine and they narrow towards the belly, they are not copperheads. These guys also spend a lot of time basking out near the water. If you're going to go into the water and you're going to get cold, you want to warm up before you go in. So these snakes spend a lot of time basking. If you see a snake basking next to a body of water, there's more than likely a very high probability that it is a water snake and not a copperhead. The next most misidentified snake for a copperhead are juvenile eastern rat snakes. Unfortunately, this is the one I often get pictures of where somebody has killed the snake and then asked for an identification afterwards. As you can see, these are blotches or spots. They are not bands. They don't continue all the way to the belly. And they're also very wide along the spine. The round pupil, I think, on these snakes is actually really obvious, which is why I add that as the field mark here. You can see there's a dark band that travels between the two eyes. I think that can be very diagnostic as well. And not brightly colored on the tail. Okay, these are constrictors. They are non-venomous. The water snake before, non-venomous. Again, the only venomous snake is the copperhead here in Northern Virginia. This is a northern black racer. Again, got the pattern of spots on the back, but not all the way to the belly. And this is a brown snake. They don't get much longer than 12, 13 inches maximum as an adult. So they're very small. They can't bite. They'll musk or poop on you, but they will not bite. That's the reason it's in my hand. So again, they have blotches or spots, not bands. And you can see both of their tails, not brightly colored, not copperheads. Here is an eastern gartersnake. I would hope with the long yellow stripes to the length of the body, it would be obvious that this is not a copperhead. Sometimes people can get concerned or fooled because when a gartersnake is disturbed, they will flatten out and make themselves look bigger, and they will strike. The brown snake will strike too, but it's just a bluff. It's not trying to bite. Gartersnakes can bite. It's not a very painful bite, but they can give you a decent bite. But again, if you see one when it's calm, you notice that head is definitely not triangular shape. They can give off that triangular shape look, when they are trying to bluff, when they're trying to flatten out and look much bigger, but they don't typically have that look to their head. And I throw these two in because historically they've been seen in Arlington. There's always the probability you could run across one that is someone's pet that's escaped. This is a milk snake, blotches, not bands. And here's a corn snake, blotches, not bands. Although it's highly unlikely you'll see a wild individual of one of these species here in Arlington anymore. All right. Here are some tips. You can go ahead and pause the video if you want to read them. I'm not going to go through them all. For being safe if you're in an area where there's copperheads. The big one around here, stay on the trail. The trails are open. If it's copperheads on the trail, you should see them because it's going to be a snake on the trail. If you go off trail, you're kind of on your own. The camouflage pattern on copperheads is very good for sitting in dry leaves and being unseen. They like to sit next to game trails and wait for prey to come by and where they can ambush them. If you're on a human hiking trail, you're less likely to see them because it's well trafficked by large animals, that's us, and they're not going to want to sit there or risk an encounter. This is taken from a document called Safety Precautions in Copperhead Country, which you can find on the Virginia Herpetological Society website. There's a full document. There's also a section on making your yard less snake friendly. If you live in a copperhead area and you don't want copperheads in your yard, so I suggest checking that out. The link is here, or you can just go to the Virginia Herpetological Society and look up the copperhead there. In fact, I would recommend you check that website out in general if you're interested in reptiles in Virginia, or if you want to learn more about copperheads. And they also have some nice images of the copperhead next to some of the most likely misidentified snakes that look like copperheads, so you can see those together. Thanks for taking the time to watch this, and I hope to see you in the park in the future. And if you have any questions, feel free to email us. I don't have it printed here, but our email is gulfbranch@arlingtonva.us. If you have any questions, or if you want to send us a picture of a snake you want to identify. Again, my name is Ken, and thank you, and have a great day.